Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Dear viewers, I'm going to start a new series in which I'll give you the summary of every juz, which will help you to learn and understand the Quran clearly in a short duration of time. Today is the first day, and today I will let you know the main points of the first juz of the Quran, Alif, Lam, Mim. Al-Fatiha is the first surah of the Quran. It comprises 7 verses. By many scholars, Surah Al-Fatiha is considered to be the mother of the book. In its 7 short verses, what we learn from this surah. All praise is for God alone. He is the one who creates, owns, sustains, and looks after all that exists in this universe. He is the most merciful and always merciful to his creation. So one should despair his mercy no matter how sinful the person is. God alone is the master and supreme power on the day of judgment. All the other things non-believer worship will be of no help. Only God is worthy of worship, so one must turn to Allah alone for help and no one else. We ask Allah to guide us to the path which is the path of the righteous people. This is the end of the chapter 1. Now the chapter 2 starts. This is Al-Baqarah, meaning the cow. It is followed by the second chapter of Quran, the cow, the first part of Surah Al-Baqarah, which unfolds the nature of mankind through the narrative of the story of Adam and Hawa and their expulsion from the paradise. The chapter then moves on to the story of the children of Israel, how they were the chosen people of the God and how they broke the covenant of the God and how they disobeyed the God. In this surah, there is an important lesson from the story of the cow. This chapter comprises of these points. Allah divides mankind into 3 categories, believers, disbelievers, and hypocrites. He also describes the characteristics of the hypocrites. The story of the cow contains great lessons like beware of faltering when faced with Allah's commands and do not disobey or ridicule them because to do so leads to hardness of the heart. Beware of the danger of preventing Allah's remembrance in the mosque or moving to destroy them. Who built the sacred mosque as well as how and why it was built? In this verse, Allah responds to the Jews of the time and the accusation they made when the direction of the prayers was changed from the Al-Aqsa Mosque in Jerusalem to Al-Kaaba in Mecca. Importantly, Allah concludes the issue by indicating that purification of one's soul is more important than facing any particular direction in prayer. The surah also covers Allah's wisdom over a number of matters, inheritance, marriage, hajj, and fasting. The only place in the Quran to contain such detailed information about this great act of worship throughout this surah and in between even its most detailed regulations. Allah stresses again and again the necessity of man maintaining at all times taqwa to remain conscious of Allah in all his affairs. The rules and regulations concerning hajj, marriage, divorce, suckling, etc., in between which Allah stresses the importance of taqwa. The story of Jalut, Goliath, and a powerful nation toppled not by sheer numbers or might but through faith, patience, and constancy. This chapter deals with a number of issues related to guidance, Allah's governance on earth, and history of previous Muslim Ummah. Surah Al-Baqarah begins with the statement that it is Allah who revealed this book, the Quran, for the guidance of those who are conscious of Allah. Only those who seek guidance can benefit from the guidance of this book. Allah divides mankind into 3 categories, believers, disbelievers or hypocrites, and describe the characteristics of the hypocrites. Although nifaq is alluded to, the word nifaq and munafiqeen are not mentioned in Surah Al-Baqarah by name. Allah chose the human race to worthy to be his khalifa on earth and instructed others to prostrate before Adam. The story of the cow contains great lessons. Beware of faltering when faced with Allah's commands and do not procrastinate or ridicule them because to do so leads to hardness of the heart. The book of guidance of those who want to be righteous, the difference between the believers and the non-believers. The hypocrites, their sickness, mischief and self-deception. Mankind worship Allah alone, make no partner in Allah's divinity. The challenge of the Quran, this book will guide many, but many will remain in error. The characters of those who shall remain in error. The story of the creation of Adam, Allah's plan and promise to send his guidance from time to time through his prophets. Addressed to Bani Israel to accept his message, Allah's covenant must be fulfilled. Warning to those who stray from the covenant of God, how some from among the children of Israel turned away from the God's teaching. God's blessing on the children of Israel and their transgressions. The real recipients of divine salvation, the hesitation of Bani Israel in sacrificing the cow. Some perversions of those who were supposed to follow the law of God. Basic principles of God's covenant with the children of Israel. Some of them were arrogant to follow the teachings of their prophets. Some rejected the prophets or tried to kill them. Some worshipped the calf, disobeyed God's commands and became too greedy for the life of this world. Opposition and enmity towards the prophets, falling devils and magic. Reminders to the believers to follow these examples. Stay firm on your principles. Some among the people of the book will try to mislead you with false claims and assertions. The true guidance of Allah is here. Read the book of Allah and follow it. The great example of Prophet Ibrahim, he and his son built the Kaaba and prayed for a prophet to come. Prophet Ibrahim submitted to Allah, and this is the message that he and his sons gave to their progeny.